Please rise. Gentlemen, if you'll kindly uncover. And please direct your attention to the stars and stripes, the flag of freedom that is proudly displayed high over the floor here at the MGM Grand, as we honor America with a playing of our national anthem. Today's first contest of day one in the Men Who Speak Up 2016 main event features the Ball State Cardinals versus the Coppin State Eagles. So time now to meet and greet the starting fives for this contest. First for the Eagles of Coppin State, and starting in their forecourt, out of Cincinnati, Ohio, a 6'7 junior, number 15, Blake Simpson. At the other forward from Newark, New Jersey, a 6'5 senior, number 3, Joshua Treadwell. On the wing for the Eagles from Upper Marlboro, Maryland, a 6'4 senior, number 22, Keith Shivers. In the backcourt at a guard from Largo, Maryland, a 6'3 junior, number 4, Trey Thomas. And at the point from Bowie, Maryland, a 6'2 freshman, number 13, DeJuan Clayton. Ladies and gentlemen, the head coach of Coppin State is Mr. Michael Grant. Introducing the Cardinals of Ball State, members of the Mid-America Conference. And starting in their front court, out of Louisville, Kentucky at center, is a 6'9 sophomore, number 41, Trey Moses. And a forward from Elkhart, Indiana, a 6'6 senior, number 15, Franco House. And a wing guard for the Eagles, check that, for the Cardinals, from Greensburg, Indiana, a 6'6 junior, number 34, Sean Sellers. And in Ball State's backcourt, at a guard from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, a 6'3 junior, number 0, Francis Kiapwe. At the point from Kokomo, Indiana, a 6'3 sophomore, number 2, Taylor Persons. Ladies and gentlemen, the head coach of the Cardinals of Ball State is Mr. James Whitford. Joshua Treadwell.
Come on,
Into the ball game now for Ball State, number 33, Ryan Weber.
Discount Tire proudly supports all Ball State sports teams and programs, and we're celebrating throughout the year with instant savings of 10% for all Ball State students and employees who show us their ID cards. At Discount Tire, you get low prices on the world's best brands of tires and wheels, like Michelin, Yokohama, Goodyear, and more. And remember, if ever you're not satisfied with one of our tires, please feel free to bring it back. Your journey starts here. Discount Tire.
It's here, it's open, and it's great. Mancino's of Muncie has a new neighbor, Mancino's Sweet Shop, right next door to Mancino's Pizza and Grinders. Get Hershey's ice cream and your favorite no crumb left behind cookie in a delicious ice cream sandwich combination. Mancino's of Muncie Sweet Shop has Hershey's ice cream in more than 20 flavors. Get a shake, cup, or cone, or between your favorite cookies. Mancino's on West Bethel in Muncie. What a great combination. What a great family place. Mancino's of Muncie has done it again.
Kansas! Go down, ball! Good ball!
Now inside.
White two, hit it right there.
Cardinal foul number two, Taylor Persons. First personal, fourth team foul.
Twice. That's a reason.
Jose,
sign up right there.
Good.
listen up. If you've been thinking about buying a new or used vehicle but feel like your past credit history is going to be a problem, well, there's good news. Go see the good folks over at Victory Honda of Muncie and let them help. Not only will you be driving away in style, you'll be on the fast track to reestablishing your credit. Victory Honda has tons of special programs to help people with less than perfect credit. So head on over to Victory Honda on West Medallion Road or online anytime at victorymuncie.com.
Does your group, organization, or business have a creative game plan? When you need banners, posters, yard signs, business cards, or other print projects.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master plan community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep. This award-winning, amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
I just came last night at midnight, leaving at 9 p.m. I love Las Vegas, you know I love Las Vegas.
Check it back into the ball game now for the Eagles, number 13, DeJuan Clayton. And entering the ball game for Cardinals, number 35, Dudu Gaye.
Hey, yo, it's all right.
Second horn?
Yes.
Thank you, guys.
Watch out, Josh.
Fouls on Isaiah Hicks. That'll be his second personal. Team's fourth. At the line, Ryan shoots two. Blake Simpson back in the ball game now for Coppin State. Foul call inside.
Baseline. White 14.
Ball State foul on Kyle Mallers. First personal. Fifth team foul. Possession arrow awards the basketball to Coppin State.
Hey,
Down the lane.
Mike, 35 block, two shots.
Cardinal foul on number 35, Dudu Gaye, his first personal. That'll be the sixth team foul. Joshua Treadwell at the line shoots two.
Shot one.
Shooter.
Hey, fellas.
Shoot.
Hey, Juan, make sure I come back.
Keith Shivers back in the ball game now for the Eagles.
Hey, logo.
Seventh team foul. Coppin State in the bonus. Dewan Clayton will be at the line. He'll shoot 1-1.
Goal by Kyle
strikes. He shivers.
In 1930, H.J. Lehman opened his heating and electric business in downtown Muncie. Now, 85 years later, Lehman's Inc. of Muncie provides that same quality.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master plan community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep, this award-winning amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
One's gambling with your investments. It's lower rates on loans and higher rates on deposits, thanks to profits that come back to members where they belong. It's the difference between being treated like an account member and being greeted as an owner. Don't worry, we'll get used to it. Ball State Federal Credit Union. You belong here.
You belong here. 104.1 WLBC FM Muncie, today's best music and the exclusive voice of the Ball State University Cardinals.
Go! Of your life, it helps to have an army on your side. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada treats more patients than all other Nevada treatment centers combined. Comprehensive is affiliated with the U.S. Oncology Network, advancing high-quality cancer care with one of the nation's largest networks of community-based oncology physicians. Comprehensive Care. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada, your best ally in the fight against cancer. You're in the fight of your life. It helps to have an army on your side. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada treats more patients than all other Nevada treatment centers combined. Comprehensive is affiliated with the U.S. Oncology Network.
And one. Basket good by Keith Shivers. Fouls on Franco House. Second personal, and that is the 10th team foul on Ball State. Shivers up the line, shoots one.
Watch your hands.
Isaiah Hicks. Third personal, sixth team foul. Franco House will be at the line. He shoots one. Time is called. There's a timeout on the court.
Renting a car, huh? Me too. I like to get on a big line, check in at the counter, fill out some paperwork, and just take off. Hey, line's over here, my friend.
Not for me, pal. I'm with Silver Car.
Silver Car. Car rental the way it should.
Trey Moses back in.
One.
Two.
Who got 34?
I don't know.
And who got 34?
Bring any rock.
This halftime announcement is brought to you by Bayer Healthcare, sponsor of Men Who Speak Up, a national education program that encourages men with prostate cancer to know the symptoms and speak up if they experience any warning signs. Thanksgiving is a time to gather around loved ones, to be grateful for all that we have, and most importantly, lend a hand to others in need. In the spirit of giving, we ask that you help us spread the awareness about advanced prostate cancer, particularly because loved ones can play a crucial role in helping men feel more comfortable speaking up. Just one small gesture.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master planned community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas, with Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep. This award-winning, amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
You want to sell me a car, John Barr? Be my guy, it's 2-on-2, and then we'll make a deal.
If you insist.
Jam.
I'll do anything to sell you a car.
Jam.
You're in the fight of your life. It helps to have an army on your side. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada treats more patients than all other Nevada treatment centers combined. Comprehensive is affiliated with the U.S. Oncology Network, advancing high-quality cancer care with one of the nation's largest networks of community-based oncology physicians. Comprehensive Care. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada, your best ally in the fight against cancer.
Our winner. Of course, they must do it before the other contestants.
Renting a car, huh? Me too. I like to get on a big line, check in at the counter, fill out some paperwork, and just take off. Hey, line's over here, my friend.
Not for me, pal. I'm with Silver Car.
Silver Car. Car rental the way it should.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master planned community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas, with Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep. This award-winning, amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
You want to sell me a car, John Barr? Be my guy, it's 2-on-2, and then we'll make a deal.
If you insist.
Jam.
I'll do anything to sell you a car.
Jam.
I can get you food. What do you want? Want pizza?
Pizza.
have someone
for a free estimate or set an appointment. 744-7950. Proudly serving East Central Indiana. Call the best, flush the rest. 744-7950. Reed's Plumbing is proud to support all state athletics.
Cardinal point guard only took two field goal attempts, off those three and a rebound in 16 minutes of action. Francis Kiapwe continues to struggle from the field, 1 of 5, all from behind the arc. Now on the season, Francis 2 for 13 from three-point land. Need to get him going. After that, Kyle Mallers, the freshman, 3 points, and Ryan Weber, 3 points off the bench, 1 of 3 behind the arc for Weber. For Coppin State, their leading scorer, Josh Treadwell, averages 11. He had 10 in the first half, 3 of 11 from the field, 1 of 5 behind the arc. After that, it was Shivers with 8, Trey Thomas 6. It was Juwan Davenport chipping in 2, as did Lucian Brownlee and Joseph Griffer with 1. Cardinals lead at the half, 40-29. We'll take another break and be back with more right after this.
In 1938, Jay Lehman opened a heating and electric business in downtown Muncie. Now, 85 years later, Lehman's Inc. of Muncie provides the same quality service and installation for heating and electric new system. If you're in need of service to your existing system, thank you.
Okay.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master planned community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas, with Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep. This award-winning amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
You want to sell me a car, John Barr? Be my guys, 2-on-2, and then we'll make a deal.
If you insist.
Jam.
I'll do anything to sell you a car.
Jam.
So need to do a better job on dribble penetration and defensive rebounding. Coppin State had 10 offensive boards in that first half. Now, if you're the Eagles, they only had 3 second chance points off of those 10 rebounds. So they're not taking advantage of that. And the Eagles have to get on track from behind the arc. They were just 3 of 14 from three-point land in that first half.
Certainly saw some encouraging signs from the Cardinals in the first half, but as always, there's always
starting the second half of play.
Well, we saw
Sean
Sellers get on track.
And the Cardinals
now
start their original starting five.
Waiting for those guys to get with it. 5 of 26 combined for those two now on the season behind the arc.
Cardinals in white, they're going right to left as we start the second half. We just are underway. Here's Trey Moses, one of the real bright lights in the first half. 3 assists, 11 rebounds, 4 points. There's a steal. Taken away at Coppin State. All the way, the shot goes up and in. Juan Clayton hitting the bucket. And the state bench exploded up in excitement, and the official running by said, hey, calm down, guys. Sellers to Kiapwe. Kiapwe deep on the right side to House. He'll shoot a 3. No. Wind off. Coppin State the rebound.
And they call
Trey Moses for, I believe, the reach-around foul, and that is that's his second.
The Cardinals, number 41, Trey Moses.
Well, Franco House left wide open for a three-point line. He's made 5 of 7 this season, so incredible statistic, Jeff. Just think about that. Franco House, 3 made threes all last season.
Treadwell off to Thomas. There's the head fake. Treadwell over Coppin State. To a certain extent, it's almost like fitting another guy, though, into the rotation because you've got the Franco House inside guy. When does he go outside and shoot? Because if he's outside, he's not inside. And they you have to kind of figure that out, too. Here's Sellers off to Persons. Down low, he tries to shoot at the Moses. Ball knocked away. Nothing wrong with Franco House taking advantage of those opportunities, but you don't want him to be your three-point weapon.
You certainly don't want to settle for a lot of those threes, but it's nice to know if they're not going to guard him out there, he's capable. And Carr's got a break there, Jeff. Very easily could have been the second turnover in 3 possessions here.
Persons has not scored. Dave indicated he's got 6 assists to lead the Cardinals. Taylor bumping in, throws it off to Sellers, a long shot, no good. Off the rim, missed 3, and here comes Coppin State. Losing the dribble momentarily was Juwan Clayton to Shivers, and now back out front to Treadwell. Throws it up off the glass, no good. And Persons got the rebound. Oh, he's called for traveling.
Traveling violation.
Turnover, Cardinals. Coppin State attacks the basket. Like a car going downhill.
This little 3-man weave, and they are dead set on getting to that painted area. So, you're the Cardinals. You got to get in the stance and play D without fouling.
Shivers to Simpson. And now on the left side to Clayton. Cuts through traffic.
Foul in the lane.
Franco House is called for a foul. 4.
Fouls on Francis Kiapwe.
Oh, and now Francis with his hands on top of his head.
Yeah, Franco, and that's his 4th as well. Franco got a break there.
I could have sworn that based on what I saw that the foul would have been on Franco House, but either way, as you indicated, a Cardinal's going to get his fourth foul. It'll be Kiapwe.
No, they changed that to number 15.
There it goes. Oh.
Franco
Francis
House.
Says, sorry if
that'll
I
be House's
cost you a foul,
fourth
Franco.
Personal.
Now, Tajay Teague will check in for Franco House, and Franco will leave the court
DeJuan
four
Clint's
fouls
line,
in 17 minutes, 12 points, four rebounds.
Here's the thing. Christian Griffin is not shy at all about playing Franco with three
Tajay
or four fouls. So
back
I don't think this
will
be a situation like a lot of teams' best players. They're holding out until the 10-minute mark. He wants to get as many minutes out of Franco, whether that's the end of the game or not.
Cardinals on offense now. They lead by 8, 40-32. There's Moses.
Well,
he got grabbed and fouled, trying to take the ball away from him was Keith Shivers. Cardinals have just lost his only double-figure score in the game, leaving. Sellers has got 9 among the players on the court. Persons will inbound it for Ball State. Shot clock, full 30. Here's Sellers dumping it back to Persons on the baseline, right side away from the basket. Makes a move, puts up a shot, awkward shot, but he drew the foul. You hear the mock cheer from the Cardinal fans.
Fouls on Trey Thomas.
Will go to the free throw line for Ball State.
First personal.
He's not been there today.
He's got a lot out of Taylor this year. Jeff likes to back in. Even though he's only 6'2", he's got
Taylor
a strong body. Does a terrific job on the block.
He was 8-10 of 12 at the free throw line prior to today. And he makes that free throw. It's a 41-32 Ball State lead. Persons got that one too. 42-32, 10-point lead, Ball State. Here's Shivers driving inside, triple team, puts a shot up high. Oh, and he got all the friendly
shots
to rim, and it goes in.
Shivers doing a terrific job finishing with a lot of traffic in there. Jeff gave him 10 points. He always is 5.
Persons. The thing you have to watch with Taylor is that right arm when he's dribbling. Here's Persons working it in the paint. Missed it. Got his own rebound. Throws it out to Chiapo. Wide open three. No. Wouldn't fall. Rebound. Coppin State. To Thomas. Takes it in. The ball wouldn't spin in. Rebound. Coppin State. They throw it out front to Clayton for three. No good. Rebound. Moses. I think they're going to get it.
Foul inside.
We're going over the back of the defender. That's what I saw. Let's know they get it to.
Fouls on Tajay T.
Jeff again.
Second
Blake
personal.
Simpson
third
was
team
the guy
foul.
That forced that foul. Simpson, no points.
Really
making his presence felt.
Check back in the
ball
game.
Coppin State.
Cardinals take
Ball
the
State
timeout.
Request a timeout.
17:05 to play in the ball game. Ball State 42, Coppin State 34. You're listening to Ball State basketball.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master planned community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep, this award-winning amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin Life. There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master planned community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep, this award-winning amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin Life.
Air conditioning dealer. We guarantee your satisfaction.
Don't fear the dentist. Find one like Dr. Pyle at University Avenue Dental and know your teeth are getting the care they need and deserve. Now featuring sleep in sleep apnea and headache therapy as well. And Papa John's is proud to be the official pizza served at Schumann Stadium in Worthen Arena. Thank you, Papa John's, for your continued support of Ball State Athletics. Football pregame show tomorrow at 6. Kickoff just after 7 o'clock. We're back here on Wednesday, pregame 3:10, tip-off 3:30, Ball State and Southern Utah. Right now, Cardinals are leading 42-34. They have never trailed in the ball game. And Coppin State has the ball. They lob it out front to Shivers. And now out it goes, a missed three for Thomas. Rebound, Thomas has got it. Took it away from the Cardinal.
12 offensive rebounds for Coppin State right now.
And there's another foul on Ball State. Taylor Persons is called for the foul. That's his second. The only player who's playing without a foul. Kyle Mallers has got one, and Sean Sellers is not fouled. Everybody else on the floor has at least two for Ball State. Kiapwe has three, and House on the bench with four. And now they call an offensive foul. Personal foul was called on Josh Treadwell. So give
first personal
Coppin State a turnover. Michael Grant, the third-year head coach at Coppin State, disappointed. Part of it, he knows his team is on the verge of being in this. They're not out of it, certainly, 42-34, but they haven't taken advantage of what advantages they do have.
12 offensive rebounds, Jeff's 3 second chance points, just haven't taken advantage.
Persons to Weber. Weber's pass was deflected. They get it to Sellers. Inside low to Trey Moses. Taking it in strong on Simpson, and Simpson grabbed it. There's Trey Moses. He just kept the tie. There's only two things Simpson could do. Let him get close and let him take a shot or foul it.
Yeah, Simpson did a good job bodying him up. I mean, Simpson's a strong guy, but he reached in there and clearly you had to call a foul if the point of emphasis is cleaning post play up.
Person in the corner to Sellers, and Sellers hit a three. Well, what a nice throw from Persons, but Sean Sellers with his third three of the ball game. He's got 12, matching Franco House as the scoring leader for Ball State. There's Shivers to Treadwell. Now it goes on the left wing to Clayton. Clayton down in the corner. Shivers over Moses for three. In and out. No good. Boy, 20% from three-point range. 31% from the field. Here's Weber. The left wing. That's Coppin State's shooting numbers. Awful. Ball State 47% from the field. 6 of 18 from three-point range. There's a pass deflected. Media timeout called for. Ball State will have the ball. 15:43 to play in the game. They lead 45-34. They've matched their biggest lead of the game, 11. You're listening to Ball State Basketball on the Ball State Federal Credit Union Radio Network.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master plan community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard, and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep. This award-winning, amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
You want to sell me a car, John Barr? Be my guys, 2-on-2, and then we'll make a deal.
If you insist.
Jam.
I'll do anything to sell you a car.
Jam.
Wednesday, we just talked about it, the Southern Utah game, 3:10 pregame show, 3:30 tip-off, Valparaiso on Sunday. Then they return home on the 29th, IU Kokomo, presented by Camping World. Get your tickets at Stoops Buick GMC Ticket Office in Worthen Arena, online at ballstatesports.com, or call 888-BSU-TICKET. Pregame tomorrow at 6, kickoff just after 7 o'clock. Cardinals over in Oxford to take on the Miami Redhawks. Here in basketball, it's Ball State 45, Coppin State 34. Match that biggest lead again. Can they stretch it?
Well, and if you're Coppin State, you got to feel pretty good that you're just down 11, Jeff. You've only shot 30%, 3 of 16. Coach Michael Grant implored his guys, saying, hey, if we can just make shots, guys, you're open. We're right back in this thing.
Taylor Persons has it. The Cardinals are in their white. They're going right to left. Persons got a wide open bath to the basket, and he laid it in. Did a nice job that time. found himself with a free lane and took advantage of it. That's the biggest lead of the game, 47-34. Juwan Davenport will take his warm-up off and get ready to come back for the Eagles. 0-5, have not played at home. They played three straight nights last week. Here's a shot inside, no good. And the rebound, Moses. 13 boards. Here's Weber for three.
High.
No. Rebound, Coppin State. Down court comes Shivers. Off in the far left corner to Trey Thomas. To Clayton. Penetrating. Missing the shot. Got fouled. And I think Taj Teague is the one who's going to be called for the personal foul for Ball State. That will be his third.
Third personal.
That's still the
fifth team foul.
Element to get Coppin State back in this game is if the fouls ring up, they hit free throws. Because I don't think they can beat Ball State. They've not shown the ability to beat Ball State with any outside shooting.
And hitting free throws is the key. 10 of 17, Jeff, from the free throw line, 58%.
Here's the second one, 47-35, 12-point lead. It is good.
Now it'll be interesting to see how long Franco House stays on the bench with those four fouls.
He's got four rebounds and 12 points in the game. Now they're going to try some full court pressure. Mallers to Weber. They aren't across the line yet. Now Taylor Persons steps across the line. 47-36, 11-point lead. Persons on the wing left, overhead pass to Weber. Weber down to Moses. Moses on Simpson, and Simpson fouled him again.
Foul at the baseline.
Simpson. That's his third foul
Blake
of the game.
His third personal.
Hicks is going to come back
Excuse
in.
Excuse me, Jeff. Five team fouls.
Fifth
Cardinals
team foul.
We talked about Coppin State getting to the free throw line. Cardinals get to the free throw line in the second half. They can stretch this thing out. Here's Weber for three in the corner. In and out. No good. Rebound comes off to Coppin State. Keith Shivers.
Check back into the ball game.
There's a Shivers taking it all the way to the basket, laid it over the rim. 9-point game. Ball State 47, Coppin State 38. Nearing the 14-minute mark to play in the game. Persons on the wing right. Dribbles in the paint. Free throw line jumper, no good. Rebound, Coppin State. Shivers down to Davenport. Missed the shot, drew a foul.
Jeff, too easy. Two possessions in a row. The Coppin State ball handler got all the way to the rim. The Cardinals simply have to do a better job of walling up on that penetration. Right now, the Eagles getting anywhere they want on the floor with the basketball.
Cardinals at 45% from the field. Coppin State mercifully at 32. Ball State 6 of 20, 30% from three-point range. The Eagles 3 of 16, 19%. They've outscored Ball State 11-7 at the free throw line. Davenport missing the free throw. They are 11 of 19 at the line.
And Coach Michael Grant just shaking his head saying, guys, we've got to take advantage of this. If you're Ball State, just 2 of 9 from the field, 1 of 6 behind the arc here in the second half.
Another missed free throw. Offensive rebounds 11-7 in favor of Coppin State. Persons, he's got 4 points and 7 assists today for the Cardinals. Teague to Persons, bouncing at the Mallers at the top of the circle. To Teague, to Weber, and back to Teague. Outside the three-point line, overhead pass to Mallers. Shot clock at 6. Kyle, his man fell down, shoots a 10-footer, hit it. Mallers had a 3 earlier, now he adds a 2, he's got 5.
Shivers wanted to charge there, fell down. Kyle just faced up and buried it.
Mallers, 8 points in his opening game, 0 in the Indiana State game, 3 Friday, and he's got 5 tonight. Here's Clayton off to Thomas. Bigger guy, Mallers is on him. 13:05 to play in the ball game. Ball State by 11, 49-38. There's a 3 up in the air, good. Juwan Clayton averaging 8 a game, hits a 3, it's 49-41, draws them within 8. Weber to Mallers. House has been on the bench for about 6 minutes with 4 fouls here. There's a turnover, Ball State. Ball knocked away, Cardinals lost it. That is their 10th turnover of the game. Coppin State's got 7.
You got to credit Clayton, Jeff, on that last Coppin State. offensive possession. You've got to respect his ability to drive. You back off, and man, he just raised up and drained it.
Gripper will come back in for them. Cardinals will have Kiapwe. Francis, 1 of 6 from three-point range. Weber is 1 of 5 from three-point range. Just amazing. Those two have struggled so much from out there. They are combined 2 of 11 in this game, and their earlier statistics in the three previous games about the same. Here's Coppin State. Their man fell down. This is Shivers. Oh, he got a pass to the basket, and he jammed it. Oh, up over Tajay Teague, and he hit the shot. It's 6 points again.
Heck of a move by Shivers there.
And in traffic. And now there's an offensive foul. Teague knocked his man almost down. And the Cardinals, just for a split second here, come a little bit unraveled.
And that was Exhibit A on what's been the issue for Ball State. Shivers took that ball all the way from the wing and dunked it.
I think that Hicks kind of, not intimidated, but I think he kind of got in Tajay's head a little bit going down court about that jam. They've got a six-point deficit, and they've got the ball. Here's Thomas getting around Weber. Now Ryan blocked his shot. No whistle was called, and that bothered Coppin State a little bit. Weber dumps it off to Mallers, gets in the paint, five-footer, won't fall. Teague followed up, tipped it in with one hand. Tajay with a nice cleanup. He's got 8 to go along with 5 rebounds. Tajay's got 4 fouls in this game, too.
Perfect 4 of 4 from the field for Tajay.
11:40 to play, 51-43, and they call an offensive foul on number 11 for Coppin State, Isaiah Hicks, and we've got our media timeout. Got a game, too. 51 Ball State, Coppin State 43. You're listening to Ball State Basketball on the Ball State Federal Credit Union Radio Network.
I think they're going for play.
Norfolk Southern wants to make it to the next game when it comes to railroad crossings. Don't foul it up. Slow down, look both ways, never try to beat a train. Cross railroad tracks carefully, get home safely. For more safety tips, go to tracksareforTrains.com.
Well, Jeff got an opportunity to see the replay of that Keith Shivers dunk. And let me tell you, that is SportsCenter top 10 material. Also, Coach Grant at the timeout, implicit to his team, continue to attack the rim. So it's going to be up to Ball State to stop the dribble penetration. Franco House checks back into the game, Jeff. 11:35 on the clock with those 4 fouls.
He went out with a little over 18 minutes to play, picked up a 4th foul early. Dudu Gaye is also in. Franco House has the ball, gets it in the paint, puts up a shot, won't fall. Grab the rebound. Weber out front, a 3. No. Long rebound of the corner. Mallers had it, but a man undercut him, and then Mallers called for the foul.
Ryan Weber, 1 of 6 behind the arc. Kiapwe, 1 of 6 behind the arc, and you won't find better looks than what you just got right there off the kick out from an offensive rebound.
21 fouls on Ball State. 4 Franco House, 4 for Tajay Teague, Kiapwe, and Mallers all have 3. Weber, Gaye, and Persons have 2. There's a free throw good. Free throw is up and good.
Well, Coppin State's going to have to do this at the free throw line. Now 12 of 21.
There's the second one, good, and it is a 51-45. Cardinals have never not led. It's been tied once for less than a minute. There's a full court pressure again. Kiapwe to House. There's a deflection and a steal. Ripper jams it. Whoa, he went up. Shivers. I'm sorry, grabbed it, jammed it. 4-point game. Closes its bin since early in the game.
Taylor House. Persons is on the bench. You got to handle this press without him out there.
Here's Weber getting the ball in the paint to House. House traveled. Everybody held their breath thinking maybe he fouled, but it was a he kind of slid to a stop. Cardinals being challenged right now. 51-47, 10:54 to play in the game. Ball State has outshot statistically Coppin State from the field 44% to 35%. But offensive rebounds are rebounding been a key. Here's Hicks. Out front it goes. Coppin State has the ball. They're down by four. Driving to the basket, and it won't fall. That was Ripper, and that foul is on the Cardinals' Franco House.
And they, I tell you what they're doing. It is.
That's his fifth.
Boy,
he
that
just
is huge.
Fouled out.
10-40 to go on this game. And,
man. Franco falls out of the game. 18 minutes is all he got today.
Joseph Gripper at the
12,
line.
Let's see. Two Franco shot. Had 12 points and 5 rebounds. Good with the free throws, Gripper, and it is a 3-point Ball State lead. Once they led by 13, twice or three times by 11.
You've got to credit Coppin State. They are doing exactly what their coach wanted, and that is attack the rim every possession. They're putting their head down and getting to the paint and drawing fouls.
New career high rebounding margin for Trey Moses. He's going to have to play big here in the final 10 minutes. Mallard driving underneath the basket, throws it out. Persons in the corner. Sellers, no. Rebound, Moses. 15th rebound. To Persons. Off to Kiapwe. No. Rebound. Comes to Coppin State. They could tie with a three. Here's Shivers on the right wing to Gripper. And they get it to Clayton. Driving the basket. Missing it. Persons went in. Ball deflected. Coppin State got another rebound try, but then the Cardinals get it.
Well, now it's about making shots, Jeff. Last two shots, perfect looks.
Persons stripped to the ball, and they say, I think, that the defender stepped out of bounds when he made contact. It'll be the Cardinals' ball to our left. Ball State 51 to 48. They lead. They led 40 to 29 at halftime. Here's Persons. Throwing it into Mallers. Kyle wanted to shoot the three, but they got on him quickly. Did Gripper to Moses. Down in the corner to Sellers. Got around his man. Awkward shot, but he hit it. Nice job, Sean Sellers. He's got 14.
Well, you got to respect the three-point shooting. They attacked him, and Sean put it on the deck, got to the rim.
5-point Cardinal lead. 9:20 to play in the game. Shivers for Coppin State. They've not won yet this season. They have gone 0 for 5. They played last Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Wednesday in Carolina, Thursday and Friday in Utah. Here's Shivers driving to the basket around his man, and he hit the shot. And the Cardinals have to lay back a little bit, or they did lay back a little bit defensively that time for fear of picking up the foul. 53-50. Here's Persons driving it into the 5-foot line. Missed it, tipped the rebound out, and Coppin State's got it. They feed it out to Davenport.
And, Jeff, they're just going to continue to spread the floor, do pick and rolls, and try to just get to the paint.
Ball State on defense. Here's Shivers. A three would tie it. 8.5 to play in the game. Clayton to the left side to Davenport and out to Clayton.
Well, here you go again. 8 on the shot clock. Here comes the penetration.
Mallers tried to pick the loose ball, feeds it to Sellers. And he tried to go with a behind-the-back dribble. It went out of bounds, and they're going to give it to Ball State. The defender touched the ball. It would have gone out of bounds. That's what Coach Grant is saying. Well, if you just let it go, he tried to save it, did the Coppin State player, and he couldn't. So now Ball State will get it on their baseline to our far left. 8:18 to play in the game. Tajay Teague, coach says get in the game. Sellers is going to come out. So the Cardinals will have Moses and Teague, Kiapwe, Persons, and Sellers.
Where's the offense going to come from Ball State with Franco House not on the floor? Kiapwe struggling, Weber struggling. Somebody's got to step up here and score.
Sellers leads the Cardinals in scoring. His inbounds pass deflected, but Moses has it. They double team him. To Sellers, they jammed it. Moses to Sellers on the baseline, and Shauna's got 16. Nice job, Cardinals by five.
Now it's about walling up defensively, Jeff, if you're Ball State.
Teague and Sellers out on the point. Cardinals defensively. Here's Thomas. Top of the circle, shot no good. Rebound, hustling Taylor Persons. And he got fouled. And we'll have the media timeout. Maybe the Cardinals have righted the ship here with 7:53 to play in the game. They lead by five. It's Ball State 55, Coppin State 50. You're listening to Ball State Basketball on the Ball State Federal Credit Union Radio Network.
Business printing isn't a do-it-yourself project. I suggest calling Scott Harvey or Jordan Green at
Summerlin Life, a premium master planned community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep, this award-winning amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin Life.
Back on the court. No appointment is necessary.
Renting a car, huh? Me too. I like to get on a big line, check in at the counter, fill out some paperwork, and just take off. Hey, line's over here, my friend.
Not for me, pal. I'm with Silver Car.
Silver Car. Car rental the way it should.
The doctors and staff at Family Vision Care, fully committed to you and your family's quality of life through your eye health and vision wellness. Visit Doctors Gard, Greenlee, Ashman, Wilson, and Nowakowski at Family Vision Care, the preferred eye care provider of Ball State Athletics. Ball State leading by five, 55-50. Only had one tie. Coppin State has never led. Cardinals have had a lead for 31 minutes of the ball game. Still 7:53 to play in the game. Pick up anything out of the huddle there for Coppin State?
Hey, look, it was more of the same. Coach Grant telling his players just continue to attack the rim. And so you're going to see more of that. Now Taylor Persons goes to the free throw line. Opportunity for Ball State to take advantage of that seventh team foul.
Cardinals are 7 of 11 at the line. Coppin State has outscored the Cardinals 14-7 at the free throw line. They've shot 58%. They've taken 24 free throws, Ball State 11. Persons hits his third free throw in a row. Hicks fouled out on that. He's the first of their players to foul out. Franco House fouled out a couple of minutes ago.
What a luxury, Jeff, when your point guard 14 of 16 free throws on the season. Clutch right there. Cards first time all season go to a 1-3-1.
Here comes Coppin State. They throw it over to Clayton on the right wing. They've not shot well, but they've been in this game. They've come back from being down 13 to get within three. Shot clock at near five. Here's Clayton driving the basket, hitting it. 57-52.
Coach James Whitford says, look, we're going to try to make you beat us from the perimeter. Goes to the zone, something the Cardinals rarely play, and credit Clayton.
Moses to Persons. He hit another three. That's Persons, or hits his first three of the game, but he hits another shot. He's got nine in the game now. And you asked a couple of minutes ago, even if it wasn't so much, you know, just who's going to have the offense, but somebody going to take command. And right now, Taylor Persons has started that process. Here's a shot up, missed by Coppin State. And Persons has the rebound to Sellers, trying to beat his man. Throws a baseline pass. It's thrown away. Turnover, Ball State. Sean trying to make a dangerous pass, and it failed. Here's Shivers to Thomas. Now a touch pass to Davenport in the corner. 6.5 to play. Cardinals lead 60-52.
Cards back to man-to-man.
Cardinals trying to get their record to 2-2. Coppin State trying to win for the first time in six games. Here's a pass to Shivers. Off to Davenport. Lost the handle but saved it. Now he is fouled by Sellers. And I didn't think I could say this yet in this game, but that's the first foul on Sean Sellers, the last Cardinal to pick up a foul.
And how many times have we seen it, Jeff, with four on the shot clock, the Cardinals bail Coppin State out by committing the foul. Davenport goes to the free throw line, 2 for 4 on the afternoon from the free throw.
They've had quantity there, not quality. Good, he hit that one. They are 14 of 24, 58%. Cardinals with a better percentage at the line, 69%. But fewer attempts. They're 9 of 13 and now 15 of 25, 60% for the Eagles. And that one's good as well.
And with the made free throw, it allows them to set up the full-court press.
And they stay in touch with the Cardinals. Ball State, 113-point lead. It was cut to 3 on a couple of occasions. They break the press that time. Persons nearing the 6-minute mark to play. And again, playing without Franco House, who fouled out. And there's a foul called on Clayton as the ball was knocked out of bounds. The Cardinal fans who are here, there aren't that many fans. Again, this is the first. There's another game after this, and then two tonight.
That'll send Tajay Teague to the free throw line. Tajay 4 of 6 at the charity stripe on the season.
Tajay with 8 points and 6 rebounds, playing with 4 fouls, and he missed that one wide right. Rebound, Coppin State. Juwan Davenport. Down in the corner it goes. There's a three up and good. That was Trey Thomas hitting the shot. And it's a 3-point game again. Persons gets it across the timeline. Drives it into the paint. And he hit the shot. Well, they don't have an answer for him. And the Cardinals take a 30-second timeout. Back to a 5-point lead. 6 minutes to play in the game. Sandifer Automotive Group in Winchester is locally owned and operated. If you're looking for a late model, low mileage, pre-owned vehicle, think of Sandifer Automotive Group offering competitive pricing. Sandifer Automotive Group willing to work to earn your trust. They are proud to support Ball State Athletics.
Well, Jeff, we talked about with Franco fouling out, where's the offense going to come from? Taylor Persons putting this team on his back in the second half. 11 points now to go with 7 assists. So Taylor has really done the job offensively. But if you're the Cardinals, it's going to start with the defensive end and trying to get stops. Right now, Coppin State either getting to the foul line. Last time it was Trey Thomas with the three in the corner. And 36% shooting for Coppin State, yet they find themselves just down by 5.
Persons has had 21, 26, and 15 in the three games. Franco House, 23, 21, 10, and today House has 12. Sean Sellers leading the Cardinals in this game with 16 points. He hadn't had a big game since he had his career high 26 in that rout of Eastern Michigan last year in late February at Worthen Arena. Coppin State has the ball. They trail by 5. Here's Shivers. Back out front it goes to Clayton. Shot clock at 10. Game clock 5:28. Here's Clayton driving on Persons. It goes out to Davenport for 3. Missed it. And a personal foul called on Francis Kiapwe. And there's going to be 3 free throws. And Kiapwe just picked up his 4th foul of the game.
And that hurts, Jeff. I mean, Persons did a terrific job stopping Clayton in the paint. They kick out. You want to make them take a long 3, and then you send them to the free throw line.
Free throw no good.
And where would Coppin State be had they knocked in their free throws? Now 16 of 27 from the charity stripe.
Yeah, and as I said, they've outscored Ball State 16 to 7 there. They hit that one. You got one more. 62-58, like I said, quantity not quality for them at free throw shooting. Here's the 3rd free throw for Davenport. It's a leaner, no good. He came in, tried to get it. They got the offensive rebound. Shivers grabbed the rebound. They've got the ball. They trailed by 4, 5:15 to play in the game. Persons guarding Shivers, takes it in, missing the shot, and Moses grabs the rebound for Ball State. 16 in the game for Trey. Sellers back to Persons. 5 minutes to play. Ball State leading by four. And there's a grab and a foul by Trey Thomas. Thomas gets his third foul.
Second personal on Thomas.
It's just a silly foul by Trey Thomas, fouling the Cardinals' best free throw shooter 35 feet away from the basket. Not a good idea.
Ball State is in the bonus, not the double bonus. And Persons hits that free throw. He's been lights out in there, 5 of 5.
Jeff, did you see what Coppin State did down this last time on offense? Literally, as old school as you can get, put four guys on the left side of the court and told Shivers, just take your man off the dribble.
Persons got it, another one. He's got 6 of 6 at the line, 12 points, 4 rebounds, 7 assists today for Persons. Shivers. Oh, and a great feed. Inside basket hit by Thomas. And there's a deflection, but Persons has it. 64-60 in the corner. Weber for three. Ryan Weber, badly needed, gets his second three of the day. And the Cardinals lead by 7, 67-60. Attaboy, Ryan. Inside, there's a shot, hit, and it's a foul. Basket goes. Davenport hits the shot. Weber picks up the personal foul for Ball State, his third. It's 67-62 with 4:24 to play. Davenport at the free throw line. He's got 7. Shivers leads them with 18.
Excuse me, Jeff. Davenport 5 of 9 from the free throw line, now 6 of 10.
Completes the three-point play. Erases what Weber did a moment ago. 67-63, 4:24 to play. They set up the press. Tajay Teague will inbound it with Davenport right in front of him. Teague throws it in to Taylor Persons. Persons, they trap him in the corner, but he gets it to Teague, and now back to Persons. To Teague and back to Persons. They get it across the time, and here's Weber wide open for three. Got it! They didn't get back and cover him, and he hit the three again, and it's 7-point lead for Ball State.
Two huge threes by your senior, Ryan Weber.
Shivers. Now to Simpson. Simpson back out front to Davenport. And now in the corner to Clayton. To Davenport. And it's a steal. Cardinals have it back. Persons bounces it off the Teague. To the basket. Got it! Hit it off the window. Knocked it in. Timeout. Timeout. Coppin State. The Cardinals back up by 9, 72-63. You're listening to Ball State Basketball on the Ball State Federal Credit Union Radio Network.
There's life, and then there's Summerlin Life, a premium master plan community lifestyle only found in Las Vegas. With Red Rock Canyon for a backyard and downtown Summerlin's fashion, dining, and entertainment at your doorstep, this award-winning amenity-rich lifestyle has to be lived to be believed. And with dozens of actively selling neighborhoods, there's never been a better time to start living the Summerlin life.
Coming back in 30 seconds in honor of being...
You're in the fight of your life. It helps to have an army on your side. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada treats more patients than all other Nevada treatment centers combined. Comprehensive is affiliated with the U.S. Oncology Network, advancing high-quality cancer care with one of the nation's largest networks of community-based oncology physicians. Comprehensive Care. Comprehensive Cancer Centers of Nevada, your best ally in the fight against cancer.
Ladies, tonight.
Back at the MGM Garden View Arena in the MGM Grand Hotel here on the Las Vegas Strip, the Ball State Cardinals have wrestled the 9-point lead back, 72-63, 3:45 to play. David, it's been a combination of a couple of things, but Ryan Weber, two gigantic, desperately needed threes.
Well, I tell you, you got to give Weber credit for stepping up, Jeff. He was 1 for 6 behind the arc. Taylor Persons found him on that left wing. He drained it, the confidence flowing, hit a second one, a couple huge baskets, and Taylor Persons has really played a terrific floor game, a double-double, 13 points, 10 assists, all 13 of his points here in the second frame, and Trey Moses, a career-high 16 rebounds. So now it's winning time. You've got a 9-point lead, 3:45. Close it out. Cardinals go back to the 1-3-1 zone, second time all season.
This is where you'd really love to see the Cardinals not let Coppin stay. They've been in this area before, 13-point lead once, a couple of 11-point leads. Here's Shivers back to Clayton. This time you'd like to close the door and say that's as close as you get.
Clayton and Thomas capable from behind the arc.
There's the 3-pointer for Thomas. Got it. Well, they're not going to go easily. 72-66, 3:20 to play in the game. To their credit, with the schedule that they've played and not so much difficulty of opponent, winless, but they played last Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, three consecutive days, and they have fought their tails off against Ball State today.
They have not gone away. You've got to give them credit for that. One home game, Jeff, in their first 11.
Sellers has got 16. He's done some damage, not of late, but his damage was earlier in the game. Sean's had a good ball game as well. Here's Person penetrating, kicks it off to Teague in the corner. Boy, Person's could have had a layup, but threw it into the corner. Weber to Tajay Teague, back to Weber. Knocked the man down, and they say bump foul, and they give it to Coppin State. That's the foul they haven't. It seemed like every time the whistle went, it was against a Cardinal earlier, but that time Ryan draws the foul. He'll go to the free throw line. He's 0 for 2, missed two free throws early in the game. He's only, if you looked at his stat line, saw 3 for 8, you'd think, oh boy. But sometimes it's not how many, but when. And he hit two big ones a moment ago and now gets a free throw.
And you can almost see, Jeff, the confidence after knocking those threes in looks much more comfortable. And if you're Ball State, this is where Taylor Person's handling the rock, as good a free throw shooter as he is, helps you.
Weber misses the second one. Cardinals now with 5 in double figures.
Cards go back to man-to-man.
On the left wing, it goes to Brownlee, who's, oh, that's a 22. That's Shivers hitting the lay-in, beating the defender, getting the bucket there within 5 with a free throw. The personal 5 was on Taylor. Persons will... Oh, no, Tajay Teague. I didn't see him put the 5 up. Tajay getting his 4th foul. Cardinals have Tiapwe and Teague with 4 fouls. Tiapwe will come back in the game. Game's short enough now. You don't want anybody fouling out, but the foul trouble isn't as significant as them just being at the line.
Well, with the make here, you better believe they're going to press.
Got it.
Shivers give him 21 on the afternoon. Terrific play for Keith Shivers.
Well, they will not go away. They were down by 9. It's back to 4, 73-69. Here's Person. Taylor gets it across the timeline. Clayton on him defensively, and he drew the foul. That's the element that a guy like he brings to the court that just not many players have. He can hurt you in so many ways.
Yeah, you really feel good putting the ball into his hands. As good a free throw shooter. Coach Grant, Taylor really has to be careful, Jeff. He's using that off arm to shield the defender. And that one in and out.
First miss. He's 6 of 7 now at the line. 32 minutes, most minutes by anybody on the Ball State roster. Moses has 31, but Persons with 13 points. 14 now with that free throw. Sean Sellers leads the Cardinals with 16. 5 Cardinals in double figures. Here's Shivers driving inside. Persons blocked it, and it went out of bounds off of Shivers.
Good defense by Trey Moses. Got the block, and it went off of Shivers' shoulder.
I loved Shivers that time. He caught the ball, put it down on the ground, laid it right on the floor. No fit. Here's Persons.
Taylor's really got to watch that offhand. Coach Grant is working the officials.
To Sellers inside. He throws it back out for Kiapwe, but it's intercepted. Intercepted by Davenport. Not over. 2:04 to play in the game. Inside, they attack. They miss. And Ryan Weber grabs the rebound.
Huge break there for Ball State. Clayton got all the way to the rim, just didn't finish.
Persons driving it in, missing the shot, did not get a foul. He was tangled up in the TV cables at the other end, and he goes down again. There's a shot, good. And now we'll get the whistle stopped. I think they should have stopped that sooner with the wires from the TV camera out on the floor. Taylor fell down. And do we have a – I see Troy – Hirschman out on the court.
No official stoppage of play. So. And,
oh, I couldn't find Taylor, but he was over sitting on the table behind the basket checking his leg, and he's in a little bit of pain. Signals the coaches that he's okay. What ends up happening is it's a two-point ball game, folks. 74-72, a minute 38 to play in the game. How about that? That's as close as they've been. They cut it to three. Persons has got to be physically spent on one level, but he keeps chugging, takes it in, banks it up, good. He's either fouling or letting him have a tough five-footer. He hit the bank, 76-72, Ball State by four.
Clutch basket.
Oh, shivers around Moses, got it to go. And he got fouled by Moses. And Moses picks up his third foul of the game.
Foul is on Trey Moses.
And Jeff, this must be the 10th and one attempt that Coppin State has had in this ball game. Just religiously getting to the rim and getting fouled.
Ball State is 13 of 20 at the line. They are 19 of 31. Got it. They are 62%, 20 of 32. It's a one-point Ball State lead. I got afternoon drive traffic going down the Galliard. I suggest you just pull off. No way road rage on this one. May have broadcaster rage. Here's Kiapwe. Kiapwe bringing it up court for the Cardinals. A minute to go. 1 point Ball State lead. They've never trailed. Score tied once. Biggest lead 13. Five in double figures. Persons a three. No. Rebound. Coppin State. They've got the ball in the lead. And they trail by one. Clayton bounces it off inside the paint. The shot, they lead it. Shivers did it again. One man wrecking crew. He's got 26. And they lead 77-76 with 38 seconds to play in the game. Unbelievable. They have come back so many times in this game. Here's Person bumping in the paint. Awkward shot, hit it. Wow, Taylor Persons just on sheer guts alone.
Fouls on Joshua
Jeff,
Treadwell.
You've got to love his moxie. Oh. I mean, he willed that one in, took the three, Taylor I thought Persons a little bit quick in that last possession, but said, give me the ball, get out of the way, and talk about big players stepping up at big times. Taylor Persons, huge Cardinals. Right now, and boy, could he use a timeout.
Cardinals take a timeout, 28 seconds to play in the ball game. It's 78-77, Ball State leading by one. Team partner Ball State Federal Credit Union proud to introduce the Ball State Athletics debit card, available in red, silver, and black. Get your card today. I just ordered my red one. Call 765-741-2728 or email mycu@bsfcu.com. They'll get the order process started. Show your Cardinal spirit with a Ball State Athletic Department debit card from the Ball State Federal Credit Union. Dean Foods and the family of dairy products they represent are proud to support the Ball State Cardinals and their student athletes. Dean Foods is excited to introduce True Moo Calcium plus low-fat chocolate milk. If I had a bottle, I'd give it to Taylor Persons after the game. Featuring 50% more calcium per serving than regular low-fat white milk. Find Dean Foods at the dairy case at Meijer this weekend.
Well, set the stage here. Coach Dave Whitford called their final timeout. No more for Ball State. Coppin State has two. And you have to believe they're going to put the ball in the hands of Keith Shivers. He's got 26 points. Jeff, in their first five ball games, he had 27.
What did he
so
have?
A huge afternoon for Shivers. And here's an interesting thing. The last couple of defensive sequences out of the timeout, Ball State went to that 1-3-1 zone to try to head off some of that penetration. So
Shivers
we'll
had eight at halftime.
We'll see what Ball State does on the defensive end, but a huge free throw. Either way, it's going to be a one-possession game.
Draw back a line to that jam he had on the drive to the basket. Here's Persons, and it goes in. Ball State leads by two, 79-77. 28 seconds to play in the game. Coppin State has the ball. They trail by two. They briefly took a lead, and the Cardinals, Taylor Persons, took it away from them. Here's Thomas.
Trey Moses on Shivers here.
Cardinals on defense. Here goes Thomas, or that's Shivers, got his shot blocked by Moses. Sellers caught it out front. And he got fouled. Trey Moses with the defensive stand for the Cardinals.
And how about that setup, Jeff? You have Trey Moses at 6'8". The responsibility of guarding the 6'4 Shivers, and Trey bodied him up. A terrific job of getting the block without fouling.
I don't think
fouling.
Shivers quite knew what to do when he got in there and the door was closed.
And I think he got away with a travel, but
yeah.
Nonetheless, that was a great defensive sequence by Moses. Huge free throws here.
Two Sellers
would make this a two-possession game.
Sellers has 16 up until just a few minutes ago. He led the Cardinals in scoring. Oh, he missed the free throw. Persons has 19 now. He leads the Cardinals in scoring.
And now this is a one-possession game.
Yep.
Coach Whitford's philosophy is not to foul in these situations when you're up three. So,
and now he misses that one, so a two could tie it and send this thing to an overtime. Here down court comes Coppin State. The shot, no good. Cardinals with a rebound. Piakwe, the rebound. Game's over. That's it. The Ball State Cardinals have defeated Coppin State here in the first round, or the first game in Las Vegas.
Ball State.
A final score 79-77. The Ball State Cardinals beating the Coppin State Eagles. A little bit of tempers after the ball game, but the Cardinals have won it 79-77. Wow, Francis Kiapwe with a big rebound. Couple of heroes on both sides, none bigger than Keith Shivers for the Coppin State Eagles and for both Taylor Persons and certainly Ryan Weber with a couple of big threes, a number of heroes for the Cardinals, but job well done for Ball State. As it turns out, they get the win.
Well,
might not have been pretty.
It wasn't pretty, but like you said, Cardinals get the W and made some winning plays at the end. Sean Sellers missed two free throws. Coppin State came down. Clayton got all the way to the rim. I saw the replay. I thought that was a good no call. They wanted a foul on Taylor Persons. I thought it was a good no call. He just didn't finish with that left hand, and the Cardinals survive here in Vegas.
That's a good word for it. 79-77. The Ball State Cardinals win. They beat Coppin State